class 4, welcome back to science class. So as you all know that we are doing chapter number 4 and we have almost completed all the topics discussion, right? Now today I am going to take a revision class where I will be discussing about the topics which we have covered up in this chapter. So as you can see on the board, and you will also recall with me, in this chapter we have learned what is habitat, what is adaptation, then what is the need for adaptation. Now as you know, like in the video you have seen that we have explained why there is a need for adaptation in order to survive in a particular habitat, to in order to search the food, shelter, and also for reproducing the young ones, and also for protection. Okay, so for all this purpose we need to adapt to a certain environment or certain habitat, right? Then we have also learned adaptation to different habitats. Now different habitats means how many habitats we have learned about? We have learned about 4 types of habitat, okay, and the animals and their adaptive features we have learned, no? Like terrestrial animals, we have learned about their habitat, like, no, their adaptive features. At the same time, then we have learned about the aquatic animals, amphibian animals, and aerial animals, and also their adaptive features, right? Then we have also learned adaptation for food. Like there are 3 kinds of adaptation for food. According to the food habit of animals, there are 3 categories of adaptation for food, that is herbivores, omnivores, and carnivores. So we have learned about that also, and we have discussed it. Then finally, last but not the least, we have also discussed why animals are important for us, okay? Then how should we take care of them, and what are the ways by which we can take care of animals or protect animals, okay? So these are the topics which we have covered up in this chapter number 4, that is adaptation in animals, okay? Today I am going to discuss with exercises and question answers here. Now you can see, you take out your book, page number 38, exercises, question number 8, fill in the blanks. I will be reading out the question as well as the answer. I am not writing the answers over here, but please do listen carefully, and simultaneously you can write the answer in your book also, okay? And after writing the answer, you will send me your work for correction. Now we'll start the exercise from page number 38, fill in the blanks, question number 8. The place where a particular type of animal or plant normally lives is called its habitat. The answer is habitat. Land, second one. Land animals that live on trees are called arboreal animals. If you have doubt in spellings, please look into the book and write the correct spelling. Then question number 3. Dash animals have well-developed body and sense organs which enable them to sense changes in the surrounding. The answer is terrestrial animals. Next one, 4th. Frog and toads are example of amphibians. Okay. Number 5, birds have dash body that help them to cut through the air and fly easily. So what shape body do they have? They have streamlined body, okay? Number 6, and the last question of question number 8. The front teeth of omnivores are slightly chisel shaped that help them to bite the pieces of animals or plant. Okay, done. Now we move to question number B. Pick the correct answer. Absence of any living being may result in what? The options are given: balance in nature, imbalance in nature, protection in nature. The answer will be imbalance in nature. If any one of the animals is missing from the environment, then there will be an imbalance in nature. Question number 2. Dash have powerful jaws, sharp incisors, and pointed canine. Which animal do they have? They are carnivores. Carnivores will have, they have this kind of teeth. Number 3. the moist skin of amphibians help them to do what? Help them to breathe in water. Okay, the options are protect from enemies, swim in water, breathe in water. The answer will be breathe in water. Okay. Now question number 4. Squirrel is an example of amphibian arboreal animal, aerial animal. So the answer is arboreal animal because they live on trees. Okay. Summer sleep is another name for, the options are hibernation, adaptation, estivation. So the answer will be estivation. Question number 6. What is the role of sharp spine of porcupines? What is the role of sharp spines in case of porcupines? In order to protect from enemies. Okay. So the answer will be protect from enemies. Now we move to the number C question. Answer the following in one word. First one. The long sleep of animals during the cold season is called, you can write both, okay, either winter sleep or hibernation, any one you can write. Summer sleep is also known as estivation. Okay, if you write summer sleep, okay, but the correct term, scientific term, is estivation, and for winter sleep it is hibernation. Now we move to the next question of question number C. The thick layer of fat under the skin of animals which keeps them warm is called blubber, B-L-U-B-B-E-R, blubber. Number 3. Changing of colors by some animals to blend with their surrounding is called camouflage. Okay, please see the spelling and write correctly. Number 4. Vultures feed on these and clean up their environment. What do they feed on? They feed on dead animals. Number 5. Ducks have a type of feet which acts as a paddles and help them to move forward while swimming. So what kind of feet do they have? They have webbed feet. W-E-B-B-E-D, webbed feet. Okay. Next, last one of question number C. This helps the elephants to reach for leaves from tall trees. So which part of elephant helps them to reach to leaves from tall trees? Is their trunk. Okay. Now we move to question number D. Match the following. First one, herbivore, answer will be cow. Carnivore, answer will be lion. Please write the number beside the correct answer. Omnivore, bear. Then camouflaging animals, it is chameleon. Aquatic animals, seahorse. Aerial animals, bird. Arboreal animals, monkey. Okay. So here we complete the exercise of the book. Now I have prepared some questions for you and you will write these answers in your copy. Okay, there are about 11 questions which you will be writing in your copy. Certain questions answer I have not written because the answers are given in the book itself. So you will be writing the answer from the book as it is given. Try to frame it short. Okay. The sentences, make it short and try to write in your own words. Take help of your parents as well as your book. Okay. See here, I will be sending you this question answers. In the description box, you will get a link. Please see from there and copy down the answers. And the book exercises, you will be doing in the book itself. And please send me your work for correction. Okay. So here we complete this chapter, children. Please do read the chapter and if you have any doubt, ask me in the comment box and please do send your homework, okay, for correction. That's all in this video. Take care and bye.